I'm being attacked by a cat. And I finally put all of my beads onto my board. And the cat is literally just over there. And she keeps meowing at me. In fact, I think she's going into a basket.
Yeah, I've got a basket. Don't question it.
And I think she's about to go lie in it. Or claw or something in it.
I have no idea. But anyway, yes, quite. I have games. Lots of games. So, I recorded my Gaming Pickles video yesterday thinking, that's the end of it. And she just knocked the basket on the ground and scarpered for her life. Oh, now she's back.
I would stop the video, but you know what? I don't even care. I don't care. So basically, I recorded it yesterday, I rendered it, and I was like, yes, I am going to upload it today, and it's going to be fun. But before I uploaded it today, I was like, I'm just going to take a quick train journey with my girlfriend to a major city that's right real close to me. Like I said, I'm in a really great area where there's so many game shops, and I've got a major city near me, which also is full of amazing game shops, and including two cash generators. Word of warning, guys. You have to. You literally have to check all your local cash generators, because some of them are shutting down. According to them, there's the two in the major city that I went to today, they're both shutting down. Yeah, they're keeping the ones in the area around me, but not the ones in a major city. Questions? I don't know. Maybe they make more money than them? I don't know. And apparently they're shutting down all the ones in Scotland as well. So, heads up to everybody. Go there. They're having a clearance sale. They are selling everything dirt cheap. Not only that, but I acquired this today. Boom! Guitar Hero 1 controller with the game. For a grand total of £1.20 from cash generator. Boom! £1.20. You cannot and will not get a better deal, except for free, obviously, for that. Let me just bring the microphone up here. Now you can actually hear me properly. Damn it, Dan. Damn it, Dan! So, yes. And also, not only that, but I picked this up for £3. What's this? Well, you might be able to tell from the side. It is the DJ Hero turntable for £3. I picked up the game for a fiver because I don't have the game. What's the point in the controller? I got the dongle as well. Now, hilariously enough, it was pouring it down with rain, and I checked it. Turned out, I picked up the Xbox 360 one. Now, as you guys know, I don't have an Xbox 360, so I quickly went back and swapped it out for a PlayStation 1, which they were very happy to do. So, yeah, I've got DJ Hero now. It could be terrible. I don't quite care, to be honest. I wanted it for a while, and for £3, I'm not going to go wrong anytime soon. So, yes, I've picked up DJ Hero, and now you know I've got the game as well. So, boom, there's the game as well, and the USB dongle. I've got a bag right next to me. And here's the dongle. It looks just like the others. And hilariously enough, on the back it says wireless turntable receiver for PlayStation 2 and PlayStation 3. So, apparently DJ Hero's out on PlayStation 2. Need to keep an eye out for that one. I'm going to go grab it, because you're belonging to me now. Boom, so that's a couple of things I picked up now. Guitar Hero 1 with had a little guitar, checked it out, all the buttons are perfect. Comes with everything. So I've got this big, huge bag of games. I don't know how many games are in it. I don't know, so I'm going to go through the accessories first. Found this. I was like, what is this? It's a PlayStation 1 gun. It could be terrible. It might not even work. For 99 pence, I'm willing to not care. I don't even know if it was 99 pence because everything in this bag was a tenner. And I'm about to show you everything that's in it. There's over 20 games in there, I think. I swear there's over 20 games in there, including all these accessories. All came up to £10.88. They're having a really, really delicious sale, and it's great. And they gave me 5 PS1 games, pretty good PS1 games, for £1. Because I think she just wanted to get rid of them. But still, cash generator, I love you. So yes, I picked up another light gun. So now I've got 3 light guns for the PlayStation 1. Lovely. I also picked up this. Now, I went to one cash generator, that one was closing, and they didn't really have a sale on for this. I went to another cash generator, they had boxes all over the floor with loads and loads of stuff in it, like controllers. They had a whole bunch of Xbox controllers, which I wish I picked up. They got a whole bunch of controllers, so if you're near a major city that has 2 cash generators in it, go check them out. I'm not even going to tell you which one because, you know, because reasons. Now, this was £1.99. This is the PlayStation Move Eye. But what's the point in the camera without the controller? Where are you? You're in here somewhere. I bought this for £1.99. I don't know if it really was £1.99. Like I said, if you add everything together, it's a lot more than £10. For some reason, I got it for £10.88 for the lot, so this was included in that. I got this, and they threw this in for free. I was like, there's no label on it or anything. I was like, how much is this? And they were like, yeah, throw it in the bag. They threw it in the bag and gave it me. So I got the PlayStation Move set for £2 from Cash Generator. Bloody Nora. Amazing. I am in shock. I don't know if it works. Might not. Eh. I'll test it out later. I've got a couple of Move games. I'll probably try it out on... Is it Resident Evil 5? No, it's not Resident Evil 5. Which one is it? Resistance 3, Killzone 3, and I think that's it for motion controls. Whatever, I don't care. I'll buy more games if it works. So now, to the games. Literally a whole bag of games. Do I have any more accessories in here? No, I don't think so. Now, these are mostly PS1 games, but they're not bad PS1 games, which makes it even more awesome. This one I picked up because... it didn't have a price on it, and I imagined it was cheap, and it turns out it was. Shrek Super Slam for the PlayStation 2. I'm just going to throw that there. Let's not drop it and everything. Oh, that's hilarious. I'm going to put this before yesterday's in the video. I'm going to re-render it all. I'm going to throw yesterday's on the end of this one, because this one's going to be more important and more better than that one. So, yes, amazing. So what else did I get? I got another PS2 game called The Sniper 2. I don't know if I've got this. I've not seen the cover before, so I'm going to assume I haven't got it. It was 50 pence. Apparently, like I said, I got all this for a tenner. I'm going to add it all up, and it's probably going to be way more than a tenner. So because I added it all up, and it should have come to about 15 or 16, plus whatever they wanted for the controllers and stuff, and they just gave me a tenner. They just said for a tenner, £10.88. I was like, okay, then whatever. So I got The Sniper 2. Now, this one I didn't get in Cash Generator, so this one's not part of the bag or anything. I just threw it in the bag. Sonic Unleashed. Now, the cover inspired me, and it was 99 pence in British Art Foundation, if I remember rightly. Just went in there, found a bunch of games hidden around the corner. Boom, 99 pence for Sonic the Hedgehog. Looks pretty darn fun on the back. So, Sonic Unleashed apparently becomes a furry thing. Know nothing about it. Whatever. Boom. Not gonna complain about that. Well, so I'm going to grab all the games that aren't PS1, and I think this is the last one. I picked this one up because I don't have it, and it's only on Xbox. Crimson Skies, only on Xbox for £1.49. Probably wasn't. I really doubt it, considering all these damn games I got. So, yep, but you can battle online, apparently. I don't know if it's single player or just multiplayer only. I ain't got a damn clue. It doesn't say that it requires internet to play. So, whatever. Looks fun, and it's only on Xbox. Alrighty. Cash Generator bag full of PlayStation 1 games. Oh boy. In fact, I'm going to put the bag down because this microphone's very sensitive to noises that aren't voices. It picks them up ridiculously easy, so sorry if they're crumpling. I'll probably edit it to make it more quiet. So, the first one, I was a little unimpressed by the case, but the game I couldn't turn down was Need for Speed... Road Track presents the Need for Speed. I don't know if this is the first Need for Speed game. And the cat's attacking me. Meow. Do you want to say hi to everybody? Meow. Meow. She hates being picked up. She hates being manhandled. But sometimes wants it. She's a weird cat. She's a cat that doesn't want attention unless she wants attention. Then she won't leave you alone until she gets it. So... yes, the Need for Speed disc is in pretty good condition considering it hasn't got a top of the case. I'm going to have to try and find one on eBay. It's probably unlikely. And cat, stop meowing before I kick your ass and throw you. I will throw you. There you go, straight your belly. There you go, get out of here. Now this one I picked up because of Echo the Dolphin. This one's called Fluid. It was another one that was meant to be 99p. I don't even know why I'm saying the price because it all wasn't 99p each, obviously. So, yeah, Fluid. This is Fluid, a unique interactive sound lab that enables you to compose infinite music sequences covering all genres of dance music, navigate this incredible ambient world and access over 600 samples, an entire studio of audio effects, and an 8-track mixing desk and interactive light show. And it shows a dolphin swimming around on the back. Now, I got it just because of Echo the Dolphin. It's probably nothing to do, or nothing even like Echo the Dolphin, because it's a sound lab. So where you can make your own music and stuff with samples. So I'm interested. I am interested. I've never heard or seen that ever. And now I found this one, the Need for Speed Road Challenge for PlayStation 1. Obviously, these are all PlayStation 1 games. Now, this one looks pretty darn fun on the back. The graphics look typical PlayStation 1-esque, but it looks like a pretty darn fun racing game. Need for Speed, they've always been good, always been great. My biggest love is obviously Underground, but I like that one as well. This one I picked up because of the cover. Roll Cage. Now, the car on the front of it here, it reminds me of those remote control cars you can get that you can flip upside down and they can still drive. And you can flip it. You can just literally flip it all around, and sometimes they even have a flip mechanic so you can literally flip them on purpose. But even if you accidentally flip them, they'll still drive, and they'll drive pretty much anywhere. And that's pretty much why I bought this game. It's apparently a racing game, pretty much like it. Apparently you can shoot things as well, so it's probably got Mario Kart, Crash Team Racing-esque ideas behind it. So I'm definitely interested to see how Roll Cage turns out. Ugh. Now these are part of the game. Now where's the other two? I grabbed 5 games, and she wanted a quid for them. That was one of them. No, it wasn't. Ah, whatever. I'll find them as I go through. So, yeah, Centipede. That wasn't one of them, but this is another game I found. I love me some Centipede, and I knew it came out on PlayStation 1. I could never find a cheapo of it. I did today. Centipede. I absolutely love myself some Centipede. I really do, especially Millipede. Lovely. So, boom. Got Centipede on the PlayStation. The graphics on the back look very simplistic, I guess. I don't know if you can make it out because webcamness. Yeah, I don't know if this one's part of it. I don't know. It says PlayStation games only £9.99 plus VAT. Nope, I disagree. It was not £10. It was part of the games I got all for a tenner, so. Formula 198. Now, I recently acquired in my last game pickers, or maybe the one I've just shown you, or the one I'm about to show. I don't know. I got it recently, in the last 3 weeks, anyway. Formula 197. So here's 98. Whatever. Saw it and picked it up. Now those three are part of the 5 that I got. That was part of the 5. And that was part of the 5. So here's the 5 that I picked up for just £1. Now, even you guys know that this should be nowhere near £1, and I got an absolute awesome deal. There's Lego Rock Raiders, which I know for a fact is a couple of quid. The Dukes of Hazzard 2, same goes for that. Elmo's Number Journey, not so sure about that. Dark Light, never heard about it. Scars, not sure about that one, but definitely Lego. I know Lego's worth quite a few quid, so even then, the fact that I got a quid for all 5 of these in cash generator is ridiculous. They weren't even in the boxes or the shelves with the rest of the games. They were behind the woman on the cashier, you know, in a special area. So I grabbed them all, left the sport ones, and picked it up. So the first one is the Dukes of Hazzard 2, Daisy Dukes It Out. I love me some Dukes of Hazzard. Absolutely love that. Not a big fan of the games, but definitely a big fan of the Dukes of Hazzard. So, boom, picked that one up. Disc is in great condition, and I'm looking forward to playing that. The next one is a little game called Scars. Not so sure about this. Maybe it's more like Mario Kart and Crash Team Racing, you know. I think it might be like that. Half animal, half machine. Scars is ready to rip the road to shreds. Join in a frenzied 3D arcade speed fest with multiplayer racing and tooth and claw combat. In the cars, of course. Which, there's a lot of these games on the PlayStation 1. I'm really happy to see that because I love games like that. And yay, and the cat's back again. Now this one I picked up because of the name alone. Never was a big fan of Sesame Street. I will admit that. I'm sorry to big fans of Sesame Street. But Elmo's Number Journey. It's probably some game for some 2-year-old. I'll probably never play it. And it even says thank you on the back. What does it say? Thank you. The money that Sesame Workshop receives when you buy a Sesame Street product is put back into Sesame Street and other Sesame Workshop educational projects. I really doubt the cash generator contributed money to you. Sorry. So don't say thank you. Now, the next one is Dark Light Conflict. No, I know nothing about this, but the the case alone looks pretty darn interesting. It looks spacey, flying around, shooty thing. That looks like a Klingon bird of prey. A little bit like a Klingon bird of prey, which I was very amused by. It's a space combat type game. It's got real-time lens flares and light sourcing on a PlayStation 1 tile. That sounds very interesting. The fact that you can run around and shoot things, you have been chosen from the elite of Earth's pilots, transported across deep space to fight for an alien race. Genetically enhanced, you became one with your starship. Okay, that's cool. You won't have time to enjoy the view, not while wave after wave of enemy ship assault your mission after mission, and all that separates you from imminent death, speed and skill. Sounds interesting. Dark Light Conflict. Pretty awesome game. I want to check all five of those games on eBay, and I hope I'm going to be impressed with how much they are. Now, this one is pretty damn cool. Lego Rock Raiders. Apparently, it was £5 on the back. Nope. I got all five of those games for £1. Just one measly pound coin. So, yes. Quality guarantee for 1 year, or we will exchange it. The shop's not going to be open for much longer. I think they said they're going to be open for 4 more weeks and closed. So, yeah. So, Rock Raiders, it's a Lego game. I do like my Lego games. So, boom, got one on PlayStation 1. Really looking forward to play that. How many games we got left? How many games we currently at? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Oh, I only got 19, not 20. But I did pick up Guitar Hero, so that technically makes 20 games from Cash Generator. However, all these here, minus Sonic Unleashed, was bought for a tenner. Boom. Which includes the PlayStation Move, the controller, and the gun. All of that was a tenner plus these four games here. Now these two I already had, but I picked them up because super cheap and whatever, I'll sell them on eBay. Like I said, I'm gonna do that for the experience, see what it's like. Probably not make any money on it. I don't really care. I just want to see what it's like, see if it's something I'm interested in doing. I picked up Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets and the Philosopher's Stone on PlayStation 1. Apparently they were going to be 49p each, but as you guys can see, no. A little bit less than that. So I picked these two up. I am going to sell these on because I already own them. So, definitely going to be interested to see how much I get for them. Probably nothing. Probably even lose money because I've got to pay for sending them out and also listing them. So, I'll get pennies back even if I sell it. So, whatever. I'll live. The next one I picked up is Railroad Tycoon. I'm a big fan of Railroad Tycoon. I've played it a lot on PC. It's a very, very fun game. And I didn't even know it had a PlayStation release. So, I'm interested to see how nasty it looks in its pixelated goodness on the PlayStation 1. Yes. Apparently it's pre-owned. You don't say. Oh, it was made by Gearhead. Well, how about that? Yeah, it's 3+. Oh, you're getting dangerously close to the microphone. Now, the last game I acquired is Rascal. I think that's a Z or something in the background. Or it's an Hourglass. So, of course, it's an Hourglass. Rascal. Trademark. I wonder if they've still got the trademark. Who published it? Can't really see. There's a sticker in the way. So, this game is Find the Secret Time Tunnels to the Past, Present, and Future. Discover 18 unique levels within 6 3D real-time settings. Rebuild the time clock, the pieces with which scattered through time and space. Rescue your dad and save the world from Cronon. Okay. The evil time overlord and his army of baddies. Do all this and get your homework in on time. Now, the one reason I got this game is because it looks like you're sliding around and jumping around and stuff. Because there's this, like, minecart section, which reminds me of the minecart section in Croc 2, I believe. So, definitely interested in playing that. Just because of that section, it looks like he was sliding around here, like in some of the Sonic games. So, definitely looking forward to playing a game quite like this. So, boom! That's all the games I got from Cash Generator. All for a tenner. All that was for a tenner. Ridiculous value. So, yeah, I'm going to end this now. It's been 20 minutes, and I believe the next segment is 37 minutes long, which is a lot of games. I've acquired a lot of games over the past 3 weeks. And I explain a little bit, like, where I've been and stuff in the next segment. I can't remember. It was yesterday. I've slept since then. So, yeah, thanks for watching and stay tuned for the next segment, which is right now. Welcome to Gaming Pickups number, insert number in the title and the thumbnail. I've been away for a while. I've just made a video, so if you want to watch that video and update and see why I've been away and my rambling, I literally do ramble. Then again, I ramble in most videos, but I definitely rambled in that video. It was about 5 minutes of me rambling. So if you enjoyed me rambling, here's a little update announcement. Well, not really announcement, just a I'm back video, which is about as interesting as a slug crawling on a wall on the other side of the world. There you go. That's how interesting it is. But anyway, this is Gaming Pickups. And boy, do I have a lot to show you. It's been 3 weeks since my last Gaming Pickups video-ish. 3 or 4 weeks since my last Gaming Pickups video. I did tone down the buying, hence why no video. However, I went a little mental this week and bought the majority of this stuff in the last few days alone, hence why I'm making this video right now, and you should probably enjoy it. So, first things first is something I don't know if I've shown you. I got it before I stopped making videos and I've been playing on it. It's been real fun. But I don't know if I've told you guys I've got it. It's the N Joypad. I don't know if I've shown you. I'm going to have to watch all my other videos. Or simply, I don't care. Basically, the N Joypad is... It looks a bit like a PlayStation. It takes discs. But it's not actually discs, it's buttons inside the console. You put the discs are all different sizes. You've got normal CD size, and then you've got one that's one of the GameCube size discs, and you've got one that's even smaller than that. You put them in, the small one presses one button, the larger one presses two buttons, and the normal CD size one pushes three buttons, and that activates the built-in games, because apparently there's games on the disc. Doesn't quite work like that, it's all buttons. So you can just put blue tech on it if you lose the discs. Because I'm missing the tiny disc, I think, disc one. Yeah, I know I'm missing one disc. I got it off eBay. I don't know if I've shown you it, but there you go. Consider it announced and shown. So, yes, that's one plug and play. Now, the next plug and play is... Where's the box? Boop. The Ultra 8-bit video game. It looks a bit like a GameCube. It is a NES pirate clone, I think the term is. It looks... Hilariously enough, like a Nintendo 64. It's the Argo Ultra 8-bit. It takes NES controllers. And it also has a gun. Let me show you the gun. Because the gun is the most impressive thing about this damn thing. Because it looks just like the NES gun. Basically, this actually takes cartridges. I'm not even joking. It's a plug and play that takes games. This is a 84-in-1 cartridge. Goes into the top. Ah, boom. It's in. How about that? Hilariously enough, this plays Japanese Famicom games. So not only does it play the games it comes with, it plays Famicoms. And apparently, according to a couple of sources, it plays US imported NES games. So I'm willing to give that a try. It's pre-owned, so it's not very... nice smelling, and I've actually had some problems with this one, so this one isn't the one you're going to be seeing, because I'm sending it back, because it doesn't work at all. Me and my girlfriend spent the entire afternoon trying to get it to work, and it wouldn't. It powered up. The most we got out of it was a yellow screen. No sound. That was the most we got out. A yellow screen once. The rest of the time it was just a black screen, nothing. So, a little sad about that, so I'm sending it back. The guy is being a real nice guy about it. He had two of them, so he's sending the other one tomorrow, and I'm sending that one back tomorrow. So, hopefully I'll get that back soon, and hopefully we'll see it again one day, and I'll definitely keep you guys updated and apprised of that. What's the next thing I got? Now, you guys remember this little baby that I've featured in a couple of my videos, my Wii Classic controller. I bought this for £10 from eBay, and then I found it in Sex, Computer Exchange, CEX, whatever you call them. I just call them Sex. they're in there for a tenner, so if you want them cheap, go in sex and buy one now for a tenner. Now, hilariously enough, I found this. Do you want to know how much this was? It was a fiver in the most expensive cash converters I've ever been in. Every game in there is £2. Not a pound, £2. Still angry about that. And everything else is little overpriced for my liking. In every other charity shop I've been, they've all been a certain price. But when I go in that charity shop, why am I calling that? Cash converters, they're super expensive and nasty. But I saw this while I bought a couple of games. I asked him how much it was. He said it was a fiver. I thought I misheard him. I was like, what? And he said fiver. And this is a Wii Classic Pro controller. This is worth over a £10. These are £10 on eBay. You can't really get them cheaper except in auctions. And the Pro controller is always more. And this is an official one. I should know. I've been using it on my tablet, which only accepts official Wii controllers. So I'm really happy and excited that I've got a Pro controller, which is absolutely no different to that one, except it's got better shoulder buttons and it's got grips. That's it. That's the only difference. I love it. It's great. And also, next door to that cash converter is a cash generator, which unfortunately is shutting down. But look what I found in it. A 4Gamers PlayStation 2 arcade controller. Do you want to know how much it was? I don't know if you can make it out. £1.49. That's how much it was. Because the place is getting shut down. I'm real sad to see it go. I hope it doesn't shut down forever. I don't know if they're all shutting down. I've not been to Cash Generator in a while. So I'll definitely be checking them out. But yep, found this for £1.49 in a clearance sale. And a whole bunch of games. And I got a couple for free, which hence why I got a couple of doubles. So you'll see them when I show the games. Got over 30 games. Maybe 35, 36, 37. I don't know. I'll put it in the title. But yeah, I'm more proud about this. Now, hilariously enough, I've not tried this on the PlayStation 2 yet, because I've been too busy trying it on something else that I'm going to be showing you in this video. A game, anyway. But I've had this for a while. I'm going to make a video about it. This is a PlayStation 3 converter. Basically, this converts PlayStation 1 and PlayStation 2 controllers to USB. So I've been using this on a game, on a very specific game, on the PlayStation 3, and it is incredibly fun. Me and my girlfriend are having a blast. But can you guess the game before I show you? I'll give you a hint. It's not a fighting game. There you go. I'll leave that one to stick around, and oh my god! We're in 7 minutes already, and I've not even shown any games. Right. How many games have we got? Well, we got this pile. Let's throw them there. This pile, I'll just throw them there, throw my mouse out the way, and I got this pile. So yeah, nice three piles. Let's start from jump cut. I've never had to jump cut in a video before. I'm not really a jump cut person kind of guy. So anyway, yeah, I only did that because I didn't want to do the PS2 games. I want to do them last. I always do the PS2 games last because I've got that many of them. PS2 games last. So, let's do the worst games first, which I'm embarrassed to say is my PS1 games. So let's get the most embarrassing one out of the way first, so it can quickly disappear from your memories. There we go. Next game. I'm not going to say anything about this game. I'm just going to leave the name with you and the cover. There we go. I'm not even going to talk about it because it was cheap. It was cheap. It was about 50p. Whatever. So yes, I accidentally acquired this one. However, let me just put it in order. There we go. I picked up cash converters. As I've said in my previous Game Pickles video, cash converters are pretty much not stocking PlayStation 2 games anymore. I think they are, but they're just not with any kind of love anymore. They're all 50 pence each now, and they're really, really throwing them all out, including PS1 games. So naturally, I picked up ones I don't have, such as WWF, SmackDown. Now, inside of this is WWF SmackDown, and I think the case is busted, hence why the disc is... Yes, the case is busted, so the disc is bouncing around. So yeah, they were all 50 pence each, these PS1 games, but hilariously enough, this someone, not me, I don't do that, sneaked this in. I thought it had two discs in it, maybe they thought it is, but it's got Hardcore, well, ECW Hardcore Revolution. Apparently it's exactly the same as a WWF game, which hence why it probably came in the case. I don't know why, but when I got home and opened the case, I found this in it. I thought it was a second case, gave it a Google, apparently it's its own game, so I got two games for 50p. Not complaining about that. I'm not really a wrestling fan. Not a wrestling fan at all, even though I do have a wrestling game on Game Boy, but I think that came with the Game Boy. Or maybe my dad bought it for himself on my Game Boy. I don't know. I've never been a fan of it, but yeah. I also picked up a game that I have no idea. I don't even know what this is. Speedball to the 2100. The year 2100, super corporations ruthlessly dominate the submissive masses. Ooh, they like being submissive. In a world where there are no wars and no crime, violence has become a sport. A sport with no rules, where only the fittest survive. That sounds fun. Combining the fast tactical nature of a sports simulation and the satisfying limb cracking of a beat 'em up, Speedball 2100 pits 16 heavily padded teams against one another in an ultimate futuristic ball game. That sounds fun. It, on the back, it kind of looks like the game they play in Starship Troopers, which looks a bit like a mix between hockey and basketball. Maybe. I'm not sure. Was it Starship Troopers? I'm just going to shrug. But anyway, Speedball 2100. I don't want to stick too long in one game. I picked this up because, you know, I've been trying to get into my racing games more, and I didn't have this one, so I grabbed it. Formula 1 97. It's got an in-cockpit view, so it'll go well with my PS1 wheel. Really looking forward to playing with my PS1 wheel. I don't play with my PS1 wheel as often as I'd like, so I'm hopefully going to play that. Probably never going to play this one. Again, it was 50 pence. Madden 98. I do like Madden. I do like myself some American football. I like the sport. I can appreciate it. It's not as good as rugby. I love rugby more. But I do love the devotion behind American football. And whatever. Madden 98. Whatever. I'll probably never play it, though, because I'm not interested. Now, this one I picked up because of Streets of Rage. Fighting Force 2. Now, Fighting Force, the first one, is a spiritual successor to Streets of Rage. It was developed as Streets of Rage 4, however, they had a fight with Sega because they wanted to go multi-platform, and Sega didn't like that, so they just buggered off and went straight onto PlayStation and came out with Fighting Force, which is in the post and on its way. Lovely fighting wheels. But I managed to grab this one as well, Fighting Force 2. However, Fighting Force 2, I believe, is nothing like Fighting Force 1. I've played a bit of Fighting Force 1 bootleg because I wanted to check it out. Because I'd already bought it, I'd ordered it, and it was on its way, so bootleg it, whatever. So I bootlegged it, played it on my tablet. Very fun little game. So, yeah, I look on the back of Fighting Force 2 and I see weapons and explosions and stuff. Prototype soldier clone created to survive any environment and fight without conscience. Seems to divert a little from the Streets of Rage area, but I don't know. I've not played this one yet, so I'm looking forward to playing it. I do enjoy the first one. Now, the one you've all been waiting for. What have I played on the PlayStation 3 with this? Only this? Midway Arcade Origins. It comes with 30 plus games in HD. It comes with Joust, Defender, Defender 2, Joust 2, Gauntlet, Smash TV being the main reason I bought this. Smash TV, my baby. Robotron, APB 720 Gauntlet, Bubbles, Sinister, Xenophobe, Wizard of War, Tubin, Super Sprint, Spy Hunter, Spy Hunter 2, and a whole bunch of them. It's even got trophies. And it was a grand total of £8. Cheaper than eBay. It's a tenner brand new on eBay. And I got it brand new for £8 from Granger Games. I walked into Granger Games, saw it, and was just like, I didn't even know this existed. I didn't have a clue this existed. I just saw it for £8 and I was like, that is a pretty darn good price for this game. Because it's a multiplat. Not a multiplat. What's... What are they called? I say it all the time and I've forgotten what they're called. They're a compilation game pack, pretty much. So, yes, I've been playing that with my arcade controller for the PlayStation 2 on my PlayStation 3. It is phenomenal, and if you do have a PlayStation 3 and you've got PlayStation 2 accessories, I do recommend getting a PlayStation 3 converter so you can convert them to USB. Brilliant. Especially if you manage to break your Bluetooth controllers, which I haven't yet. I've got 4 PS3 controllers, and every single one of them work perfectly, besides sticky joysticks. I don't get why some rubber devices do that. It's weird. I just realised what I said. Why some rubber devices get sticky. I am terrible. I have one GameCube game by the looks of it. Oh, I thought I got more. Oh, I was going to get a couple, but I didn't. I just got one. One which is critically acclaimed and everybody loves, and I think it's a hidden gem. Not for the GameCube. I think it came out on the PS2 as well, but I believe it's a hidden gem in general. It's called Godzilla Destroy All Monsters. Basically, classic Godzilla, you know, the one that shoots lasers from the amazing classic Godzilla movie from the... Was it the 60s? I can't remember. It was ages ago. But yeah, absolutely phenomenal game where you fight a whole bunch of monsters, destroyable environments on the GameCube with a tiny little disc. Yeah. Tiny little disc on the GameCube. 1 to 4 players simultaneous. Mm. And apparently it comes in a multitude of flavours in the form of languages. But it comes in English primarily, so it's good enough for me. Bought it for £4 in sex. So very happy about that. Love myself some GameCube games because, as you guys know, I don't have many. So I picked up a bunch of Wii games. Finally. Look at my Wii collection. Finally, I think... Yes, I know I've finally spilled over to another shelf. These games alone, these Wii games alone, will fill that little gap there, and that GameCube game is probably going to get relegated down to the there. But anyway, awesome. Finally got one shelf worth of GameCube and Wii games. But anyway, let's show you them. Now, this one I found in Oxfam for £2. So for £2 for a Wii game alone is fantastic. But £2 for Call of Duty 4 Modern Warfare? Yes, please. Especially considering you can use your gun accessory with it, which is fantastic on the Wii. I do recommend that. So for £2, I don't think the multiplayer works anymore. I'm fairly certain. Yeah, if I remember rightly, because I think I made a video of it on GTNR. Basically, multiplayer on the Wii is gone. So you can only play single-player multiplayer, local multiplayer. So, here you go. Boom. Call of Duty 4, Modern Warfare. On the Wii. Fun. Now, this one, I had a choice between the first one and the second one, and ultimately got the second one. I don't know. I know they're both apparently fun, but I figured I'd grab the second one, because, in theory, sequels should get better than the originals. In theory. Now, this isn't true, but time and time again, the sequels are better than the previous ones, and have better controls and stuff. So, boom. Rayman Raving Rabbids, or Rabids 2. I like my Rayman games, I've always enjoyed them. I enjoy Rayman that much, I actually spent £2.50 or £5 on mobile or cell phone credit. Back in the old days, before flip phones, it was my Nokia 3510i. I believe it was the first Nokia phone with a colour screen. No, it wasn't. It was the second phone with a colour screen, I believe, but the first with internet. That's hence the little lie. I believe the 3410 was the first one with colour. Now, old little Nokia phone. I bought Rayman for it because I enjoyed Rayman so much. So, I got Raving Rabbids, which, whatever. And I grabbed this because... Yeah, I like my games with a bunch of games on. This is no different. Game Party for £2.50. I got a whole bunch of Wii games that you can use motion controls on to play with, you know, a group of people. It's made by Midway, so it should be kind of fun. I mean, it's by Midway. They're good at making fun games to play with other people. It takes up to 4 players with a normal Wii controller. So maybe we'll have some fun with that. Maybe not. I'll keep you guys updated whether me and my girlfriend like it. A Steven Spielberg EA game. Boom Blocks. No idea what it is. It's £1.50. I believe I've looked at a video of it once. It reminds me a little bit like Jenga, I believe. Yeah, from the back of it, it does remind me of a video I saw of a game quite like it, where you have to destroy towers and stuff with explosions and stuff. Can't remember quite how you do it. That's why it says Steven Spielberg. Steven Spielberg likes his explosions, for crying out loud. And this game's no different. On the back, it shows towers, and you explode them and stuff and knock them down. And that's essentially what it is, and for £1.50, I'm not going to complain, especially considering it's four-player. So, boom. Fun. Now, what else we got? Let's grab all the PC games. Let's do all the PC games now. I don't give enough love to PC. Now, you guys know I've already got this, but I picked it up because it was 20 pence. I don't know if you guys can see it. It was in Cash Generator, the one that's shutting down, for the grand total of 20 pence on PC. Big Mother Truckers. Really fun game. It's got women and trucks, and you get to race them and stuff. So, boom. Not going to complain for 20 pence. I'd never complain about a PC game for 20 pence. Now, this one I picked up because I actually like the movies Tron, so I figured maybe this game will be okay. It's for PC, it's Tron 2.0, the graphics look pretty darn good, and it was 50 pence. Boom. From Cash Generator. Now, this one I picked up because, well, it's Sonic & Knuckles for 49 pence. It has Sonic the Hedgehog 3, Sonic & Knuckles, and Sonic 3 & Knuckles. So it's got a whole bunch of Sonic games on it for the grand total of 49 pence. It works on XP and Vista, so I'm going to assume it works on Windows 7. And even if it doesn't, I've got a dual boot, and I've got installation discs for XP, Vista, 98, and Millennium. And 2000, I believe. So, boom. Grab that. I don't know why that's so blurred out, but whatever. Yeah. So yeah, grab myself a Sonic. And the last PC game I got was a 25 pence game by the name of Pac-Max Classics. Well, I'm going to let you have a little look at the cover. What does that slightly look like? Okay. Now, let's see. I don't know if you got how much you guys can make out the back, but what does that kind of look like? Especially that one. Yes. It seems like a Pac-Man clone. I mean, you've got 3D Man, which is like a 3D Pac-Man up here. And you've got Pac-World, guide Packy through the maze using the arrow keys, eat all the dots, and evade the four ghosts. Pretty much Pac-Man. And you've got Joe Pack. Joe Pack is a peaceful guy, and you have to guide him through the maze. His mission, free Pac-Wife and stop the increase of the Grolian population by collecting their eggs. And you've got J-Man, and then you've got Crazy Maze, which looks more like the original Pac-Man. And you've also got Zap-Man. It's pretty much a Pac-Man clone. And for 25 pence, I wasn't going to complain, because I like Pac-Man. It's fun. Now let's go through the Xbox games. Oh boy. Now this is what I picked up because I liked the movie. It wasn't a great movie, but it was a nice movie and I liked the story. It was dumb, and it had dragons in it, and it had fires, an almost human extinction, and a burnt London. There wasn't pretty much not to like about this game. So, 24 AD, in a post-apocalyptic world, mankind struggles to survive under a rain of fire from the skies. You must lead a dangerous crusade to bring these flying beasts to their knees. Xbox. One player. Rain of fire. Fun little Xbox game. And this one I picked up because I enjoyed the TV show before it got cancelled. Dark Angel. A fantastic It's got a fantastic lore about it. It had a great story. I enjoyed the TV show, and let's face it, she's kind of hot, but that's not really the reason I watched it. I just liked it. I thought it was kind of cool. Like, she was kind of, what was she? A bioengineered girl, trained, kind of like Hitman 47 style. I think she was like engineered and then trained to be some sort of person, and she escaped, and now she's some leading a double life and stuff like that. It's pretty much like that. Story of Max, a genetically enhanced soldier who cunningly fights to reclaim her manipulated past to avoid capture through the underground landscape of post-apocalyptic Seattle. See, I liked it. So maybe the game's good. I have no idea whether the game's any good, but I picked it up anyway, and it was pretty darn cheap. I got it from a local game shop in a nice little goth shop. It's got this like gothic shop thing that's got a whole bunch of alternative stuff. And in the slap bang in the middle of it, in the basement, is a video game store full of classic games ranging from NES all the way up to PlayStation 4. The whole lot, the whole shebang. And this one I picked up from Sex because it was a quid. I don't know whether it's any good or whether it's terrible. Release the 999 trapped souls or you will join them. It's called The Haunted Mansion by Disney. I don't know if there was a movie called The Haunted Mansion. I don't really pay attention to children's movies anymore since I grew up. This one I picked up because of the name. And because it said only on Xbox, so I knew I wasn't going to get it anywhere else. Fusion Frenzy. Non-stop party game action. You've got 1 to 4 players, and apparently it's like kind of like a party game where you've got a whole bunch of mini-games on it, and apparently it's competitive, nice, fun. So, whatever, I grabbed it, and it was 99 pence. I'm not going to say no to a game like that, so I picked that one up. Now, this one I picked up because I thought I had it, and it turns out I didn't. I swear I had it on PlayStation 2, but I don't. So now I've got it on Xbox instead. The movie was confusing. I did get confused about it, but then again, I did watch the movie when I first got drunk. Literally, it was the first day I got drunk. That's why I remember this movie, and I've got fond memories of it, because it was the first time I ever got shit-faced. And I'm proud of it. Because it was a nice feeling, and it was a fun night. So yes, Constantine. I must find out when that movie came out. But then, because I think it was the cinema, I think my cousin downloaded a pirated copy, you know, camera version. I remember it being a camera version, so it was probably before the DVD got released. I'm going to find out when it came out in the cinema, so it'll be around that time when I first got drunk. And I'm going to find out how old I was. I know I wasn't 18, I was a naughty, naughty boy. But whatever, Constantine!
Yay!
Apparently it's a fun game. Now this one I picked up because I loved the TV series, both the old and the reboot. Now the reboot bored me to tears after a while, but I did enjoy the action sequence, I enjoyed the story, and the ending was a little okay, I guess. I just didn't like the religious undertones of it. I don't like religion in things. I'm not a big fan of religion. I don't mind religion, I just don't like it in my face, kind of like the ending of Battlestar Galactica was, like, oh god this, god that. I was like, leave me alone, just get to it, right? So yeah, Battlestar Galactica, pretty damn fun, whatever. Destroy the Cylons or succumb to annihilation. The epic battle to save mankind has begun. Cinematic gameplay, breathtaking graphics. Okay. So yeah, apparently it's a fun little space-type game where you're shooting in space. Hell yeah, not going to say no to that. So Battlestar Galactica. Now I'm going to show these two at the same time because they're the same game. I now have 3 Halo 2s. Because these are from the cash generator that was closing down. They were 50 pence for both. 50 pence for both Halo 2 games. I'm probably going to sell them on or trade them. They're cheap on eBay now. I'm not going to get much for them. I think you can get it for about £2. I think you can get Halo 2 for £2 now on eBay. So, won't get much for it. Pennies, if that. But whatever. Like I said, I'm not doing it for a living. I'm doing it for the sheer experience. And this one I picked up because I don't have it and because it was 29p. Xbox. Germany World Cup 2006. Now, hilariously enough, I have 2011, I have 2002, and I think I have 2003 and maybe 2004. But I do not have 2006, so I grabbed it for 29 pence. Any more Xbox games, so whatever. Alright, well, let's get these out of the way. How long are we at? Nearly 30 minutes. Let's get this one out of the way. CSI Crime Scene Investigation, Three Dimensions of Murder. I love the TV show, and I really enjoy the games. Is this one by Telltale Games? Because the one I got for PlayStation 3 was by Telltale Games, but I don't think this one is. No. Nope, it doesn't say Telltale anywhere. It just says CBS. Consumer Products. Lovely. AskAboutGames.com. Whatever. Yep, CSI. I do like my CSI games. They are very fun. I've enjoyed every single one I've played, so there's no reason why I can't enjoy that one, even if it's on the PlayStation 2. But I did enjoy the PS3 version, but it was by Telltale, so whatever. Now, I did already have this one, but I have it on Xbox. Now I've got it on PlayStation 2. Midway Arcade Treasures. Now, like as you guys should already know, I love my compilation games. That's got a whole bunch of classic awesome games on them. I mean, I've got Atari collections. I've got Activision, good old classic Activision collections. I've got Family Games. I've got Sega Mega Drive Ultimate Collection. Genesis. for you people in America on the PlayStation 3, which is awesome. I've also got Midway Arcade Origins now. I've got a whole bunch of awesome ones, and I've got all three Midway Arcade Treasures. I don't know if there's a fourth one. Must Google that. I need to pick that one up, because I know I've got 1, 2, and 3. So I've got a couple of ones now. Yay. Now, this one I picked up, because I thought I had it, but apparently I don't. It was 99 pence. It's called Killswitch. It's a third-person shooter by the looks of it, and it looked pretty damn fun in that I like the cover. And it's by Namco, so chances are it is fun, because anything produced by Namco can be fun. Can be. Oh, and I've also got a Namco collection somewhere, either for PS2 or PS1. That. I do have Maximo, but I managed to find this one. Maximo Army of Zin. Both Maximo games are fantastic hidden gems on the PlayStation 2. I really do recommend that you, if you do have a PlayStation 2, or hell, pirate it. Emulator, I don't give a damn. These aren't supported by... They're obviously not supported by Sony anymore, because guess what? They didn't make a sequel for it. I really wanted a sequel on PlayStation 3, but maybe they lost the licenses, maybe they didn't want to, maybe it didn't sell as well. But it's by Capcom, so you can kind of expect why it's a bit flopped and not had a sequel, because God damn it, Capcom, you fail. So yes, Maximo, really fun little games, the action platforming games. You run around, you slice things up, and you have a little jumping around again, and it kind of reminds me of a little bit like Ratchet and Clank. Little teensy wincy little bit like Ratchet and Clank. So yes, I definitely recommend the Maximo series. I picked up Army of Zin because I absolutely love Maximo. So Maximo Army of Zin is pretty damn good. Now, recently I acquired, a few weeks ago I acquired SoundScope 1 and 2. Boom, look what I found. Not for $39.99 from Game. How much was it, really? Doesn't say. Damn. I definitely didn't buy it for 40 quid, I promise you. I would never buy a PlayStation 2 game for 40 quid, no matter how rare. You know me, I only buy them for a quid or two. £2 maximum. So yes, I bought SoundScope 3 because I liked SoundScope 1 and 2, and maybe, just maybe, SoundScope 3, because like I said, sequels tend to be okay, tend to be good. And this one I picked up for the name alone. Chaos Legion. That cover looks epic. It was £2 from the expensive cash converters that I bought a Wii Classic Pro controller for a fiver somehow. But yes, Chaos Legion. The art style in the back looks really interesting, and it's obviously a game from Asia, and it's by Capcom again, so it might be fun. Chances are it is fun, and Capcom just didn't capitalize on that, because that's what Capcom do. They like to make games and never make sequels because they're assholes. Did I say that? I'm sorry, Capcom. I don't hate you. I do have love for you because of some of the games you made. I love Resident Evil, I love all the other games you made, but bloody Nora, learn to make more games. Kind of reminded me of bloody... I'm not even going to rage about it. Because everybody rages about Mega Man. So yes, I bought this one, iNinja, for the grand total of... Can you see it? £1. There we go. iNinja. Looks kind of fun. And the little guy on it looks kind of cute. It's by Namco, so maybe it's fun, maybe it isn't. I don't know. It's got a nice little PS2 shiny thing on the front of it. That's nice. And it's for PAL regions. So it kind of works. And it's not German. So that's good. This one I picked up because I can't believe I never owned it. Red Dead Revolver. I swear I owned it, but apparently I don't. I just have Red Dead Redemption, I have Red Dead Redemption Undead Nightmare on PlayStation 3. I have both of them. So I picked up Red Dead Revolver because, hey, it's by Rockstar and it's Red Dead, so chances are it's pretty darn awesome. So looking forward to playing this one because Red Dead is a fantastic series, and if you haven't picked them up, you're insane. This one I picked up because I enjoy the movies. I love the character Blade, and Wesley Snipes, I've liked him in the movies he's been in. I've liked him. Now, I think he's just got out of jail recently-ish. I know he went to jail, that's why we didn't see him in movies for ages, but I know he's out now because he's in Expendables 3, so I'm looking forward to watching Expendables 3 just to see Wesley Snipes in it, because it's been so long since I've seen him in a movie because he's been in prison. But, yep, absolutely love the Blade franchise, so I'm looking forward to playing the video game Blade. Maybe it's got his voice. I'm not holding my breath to have Wesley Snipes' voice in it. I mean, they'd probably put it on the cover somewhere if it did have his voice in, but I hope the voice actor's good if it is. So, yes, I got Blade. Do you know why I picked this one up? King Kong? I felt sorry for the shop. and I'll check my list. I don't have it, so I picked it up. I felt sorry for the shop because, where was it? I think it was Sex. They had about 20 copies of King Kong, and they were selling them for dirt cheap. How much was it? Oh, they took the cover off. I love how it's got a game sticker, and then a Granger game sticker there. But I didn't buy it from. I'm sorry, I bought it from Sex for about 50p. So King Kong, they had like 20 versions of this, and maybe it's okay, maybe it's not. Use weapons traps and your team to wisely survive, and first person is Jack. Play as man, play as Kong, whatever. The game might be good, the game might be bad, I don't quite care, to be honest. So whatever. This one I picked up because it was 75p and I don't have it. It could be terrible, it could be great, I don't know. X-Men Wolverine's Revenge. It was 75 pence. It's an X-Men game. If it's good, if it's good. If it's bad, if it's bad. I don't know. Ooh, that graphics looks terrible. But anyway, maybe it's okay, maybe it's not. I don't really want to talk about that one. This one I picked up because of my love. Because of my love for this. From Russia with Love, 007. £1.50. I thought I had it, but apparently I didn't. So now I do. Absolutely loved Sean Connery as classic Bond, you know. Sorry about that. It's my phone. So, yeah, I absolutely loved Sean Connery as the classic Bond, so really, really, really glad to see him back as James Bond. Just for one last time in From Russia with Love, and looking forward to playing it. Yay. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video. It's gaming pickups. I don't know which number it is, and I don't know how many games I've got. I bought a whole bunch of crap when I went to town. A whole bunch of crap. A lot of stuff you don't really need to see because it's not gaming related, but yeah, bought a whole bunch of stuff. Really looking forward to playing with the arcade stick and playing a whole bunch of games in there. Especially my new Maximo game because, hey, I love myself some Maximo. Definitely recommend that. I recommend most of the games on there, just not the PlayStation 1 games for reasons that I will not say. But anyway, guys, sorry for a long one. Sorry I've been away for a couple of weeks. Let's see if I can get myself back on the road with my videos. I'll see you guys next time. Take care.